What if freight could glide through the Alps without a single steep climb? No trucks choking mountain valleys with exhaust, just fast electric trains slicing under 2,000 meters of rock. Welcome to the Mont base tunnel, a 14 billion euro, 57.5 kilometer marvel at the heart of Europe's 30 billion euro plan to transform transport between France and Italy. If built, it'll be the longest rail tunnel on Earth, but it's also one of the most divisive. Brussels hails it as a climate game changer. Critics call it a costly white elephant. Costs are soaring, delays are mounting, and locals are clashing with police over its environmental toll. So is this tunnel Europe's boldest step toward a greener future, or the world's priciest hole in the ground? Europe's freight system hits a wall at the Alps. Trucks clog narrow mountain roads while the aging Mont-Cenis rail line, steep, curvy, and underpowered, struggles to compete. The Lyon Turin rail project, anchored by the Mont base tunnel, is the EU's boldest fix. A 57.5 kilometer twin bore tunnel under the French-Italian border, set to surpass Switzerland's Gotthard as the world's longest rail tunnel. It's not about records, it's about pulling trucks off Alpine roads, cutting CO2 emissions, and positioning electric rail as a rival to trucks in short-haul flights across Western Europe. Dug flat and deep, the tunnel eliminates the steep gradients that choke the current line, creating a high-speed corridor linking Mediterranean ports to Central Europe's industrial heart. Conceived in the 1990s, the project languished for decades. Feasibility studies stacked up, but cross-border disputes, shifting political winds, and fierce local protests stalled progress. It wasn't until 2021 that full-scale tunneling began, decades after the first designs were sketched. Now, with 14 billion euro committed to the base tunnel alone and over 30 billion euro for the wider corridor, including rail upgrades from Lyon to Turin, it's no longer a blueprint. It's Europe's biggest inland transport investment in decades. And at its core is a high-stakes promise to move the Alps and everything that moves through them. Carving a 57.5 kilometer tunnel through the Alps is one of the most ambitious engineering feats Europe has ever attempted. At its heart are two single-track bores 40 meters apart, connected by safety cross passages every 333 meters. Unlike the old Fréjus tunnel with its steep climbs and tight bends, the Mont tunnel runs flat, built for fast freight and high-speed trains. Suffice to say, conquering Europe's toughest rock is no small task. Up to 2,200 meters of overburden create immense pressure, while heat, groundwater, and shifting geology make this a brutal environment for machinery and workers alike. Engineers are tackling it with a hybrid approach. 65% of the tunnel is bored by giant tunnel boring machines, or TBMs, while the rest uses drill and blast for complex zones. Seven TBMs are planned. The first, Viviana, launched from Le Prat in April 2025, cutting a 9-kilometer stretch toward Italy. Spoil handling is a colossal operation. When you're digging under a mountain, you can bet that this is going to be a challenge. So the tunnel will produce 45 million tons of excavated rock, which is enough to fill a convoy of trucks from Paris to Rome. Custom conveyor belts and rope-con cableways haul it off-site, with over half reused to cast the tunnel's concrete linings. And that's actually kind of cool. And speaking of cool, ventilation is critical. Shafts up to 500 meters deep, drilled from the surface, deliver fresh air and provide emergency access for evacuations and rescues. Inside, the tunnel boasts slab tracks, full digital monitoring, and a midpoint safety station, modeled on the Gotthard and Brenner base tunnels. Again, this isn't just a tunnel. It's a pressure-sealed lifeline for Europe's rail future, built to endure for a century. The Mont base tunnel carries a hefty price tag, 14 billion euro for the tunnel alone, with the full Lyon-Turin corridor exceeding 30 billion euro, including rail upgrades from Lyon to Turin. Yet supporters insist it's critical for Europe's economy. The Alps are a choke point. Trucks jam at the Mont Blanc and Fréjus tunnels, while the old rail line, steep and slow, caps freight capacity. The new tunnel promises a flat, high-capacity corridor to shift over 1 million trucks off Alpine roads annually, cutting CO2 emissions by up to 3 million tons. That's equivalent to removing 600,000 cars yearly. That is a lot. And so this reduces congestion, road wear, and pollution in fragile mountain valleys. Strategically, the tunnel is a linchpin of the EU's 10T Mediterranean corridor linking Spain, southern France, Italy, and Eastern Europe. It transforms a sluggish, vulnerable route into a high-speed freight backbone, connecting ports, factories, and markets from Barcelona to Budapest. This could lower shipping costs and boost trade across the continent. Funding, and there is a lot of it, reflects the stakes. The EU covers 40% of the cross-border section's cost, potentially rising to 55%, making this one of its largest ever investments. Italy and France split the rest, fully funded by public coffers, with Italy bearing the bigger share. Unlike many mega projects, there's no private financing. This is a public bet on Europe's future. Still, the financial story hasn't been smooth. Costs have ballooned by billions, driven by recent inflation and geological surprises. Critics question whether freight volumes will justify the expense, especially if demand falls short. Yet, with construction a decade in and approach lines advancing, France and Italy are all in. The tunnel has left the station, carrying Europe's hopes for a greener, more connected future. For a project pitched as a climate win, promising to slash emissions and pull over a million trucks off Alpine roads, the Mountain Beam Base Tunnel has sparked fierce resistance for over three decades. In Italy, the NoTav movement, short for No Train a Alta Velocità, has railed against the project since the early 1990s. In the Susa Valley, where construction sites scar the landscape, locals fear ecological disaster. Protests have turned violent with sabotage attempts, police clashes, and at times a militarized security presence. What some see as progress, others see as invasion. Environmental concerns lie at the heart of this backlash. Critics warn of disrupted water tables, dried up alpine springs, and the possible release of hazardous materials like asbestos. In the 2010s, test excavations temporarily drained local aquifers, fueling public distrust. While geological surveys haven't confirmed major threats like uranium or widespread asbestos, because that would be bad, the project now operates under constant surveillance with enclosed spoil systems and asbestos containment systems. But the opposition isn't just environmental, it's economic. A 2019 Italian government review controversially labeled the tunnel very negatively profitable, citing freight volumes well below projections. The European Court of Auditors echoed the concern in 2020, warning the project's benefits may not match its 14 billion euro price tag. Detractors argue the existing line could have been upgraded for far less, but supporters push back, calling the current rail route a relic. Steep, slow, and incapable of shifting freight from roads. They point to Switzerland's success with the Gotthard Base Tunnel, where flat alignments and smart policy turned rail into a dominant alpine mode. Europe, they argue, needs to match that ambition. Meanwhile, in France, opposition has been quieter but consistent. In 2021, over 150 public figures signed an open letter calling for cancellation on environmental grounds. Communities in the Maurienne Valley voiced concerns about dust, noise, and spoil transport disrupting daily life. Still, the project powers ahead. In April 2025, the first of seven TBMs launched beneath the Alps, with over 30 billion euro committed across the wider corridor, including Lyon-Turin rail upgrades. Its backers say the cost of inaction, more trucks, emissions, and congestion, would be even greater. As the TBMs bore forward, this tunnel isn't just digging through mountains, it's digging through politics and protest and decades of division. To grasp the Mont Blanc Tunnel's ambition, look east to Switzerland's Gotthard Base Tunnel. At 57.1 kilometers, it's the world's longest rail tunnel, fully Swiss-funded. For now, the Lyon-Turin Tunnel will edge it out at 57.5, but this isn't about records, it's about results. Completed in 2016, Gotthard didn't just shift engineering boundaries, it shifted freight, backed by strict truck tolls, rail subsidies, and strong political support. It moved millions of tons of cargo off Alpine roads. Hard infrastructure met soft policy, and it worked. Lyon-Turin aims for the same outcome, but with more moving parts. Spanning two countries, it leans heavily on EU funding and has faced decades of political friction. That is a lesson in itself. Big infrastructure needs steady governance. Switzerland had it. France and Italy often haven't. Another Alpine megaproject, the Brenner Base Tunnel between Austria and Italy, adds perspective. Like Mont, it battles delays from geology and local pushback. It shows megaprojects aren't just about boring tunnels, they're about diplomacy and compromise and trust. Then there's the Channel Tunnel, a cautionary tale. Cost overruns, inflated forecasts, and budget blowouts. The lesson? Don't let optimism bias write your business case. That's why Lyon-Turin's 14 to 15 billion euro budget is now third-party audited with contingencies baked in. But the biggest takeaway is this. Montembin isn't just a link between Lyon and Turin. It's a test case for the EU's 10T green freight vision, from Lisbon to Kyiv. Unlike Gotthard, this project only works if Europe sees it through. If politics hold and lessons from Gotthard and Brenner are heeded, Montembin won't just be the world's longest tunnel, it might redefine a connected, resilient Europe. At first glance, the Montembin Tunnel might look like just another overhyped megaproject. Decades in the making, billions over budget, and still years from completion. But step back and it's something else. It's a test of whether Europe can deliver cross-border infrastructure at scale in an era of rising costs, political gridlock, and climate urgency. This isn't theory anymore. Tunnel boring machines are running, shafts are being lined. The 14 billion euro budget is certified and treaties are signed. This is a real project moving real rock. The challenge now isn't engineering, it's political will. France hasn't committed to completing its approach lines before 2035. Italy's support has wavered through past funding disputes. On the ground, distrust lingers in the Susa Valley after years of protests and standoffs. Public engagement, not press releases, will bring communities along. But if this tunnel opens on time in 2033, it could mark a genuine shift. Over a million trucks off the road, up to 3 million tons of CO2 saved, and faster, cheaper freight across the spine of Europe. That's not just a climate win, but a logistical and economic one too. Because this isn't just about Lyon and Turin, it's about Lisbon to Kyiv. It's about whether the EU can turn the 10T network's high ideals into concrete, quite literally. And that's the bet here. Not just on tunnels, but on cooperation, strategy, and long-term vision. For once, that's a bet Europe might win. For over three decades, the Montembin Base Tunnel has been a lightning rod where ambition met resistance and Europe's infrastructure dreams collided with political reality. But now, beneath the Alps, the TBMs are moving, shafts are being lined. A 14 billion euro vision is grinding forward, meter by meter. Like I said, this isn't just a tunnel between France and Italy. It's a test of whether Europe can build bold cross-border infrastructure amid climate urgency and local pushback. A million trucks off the road, up to 3 million tons of CO2 cut each year, a corridor that could one day span Lisbon to Kyiv. Yet, risks linger. Cost overruns, delays, and wavering political will, with France's delayed approach lines a glaring hurdle. On the ground, in the Susa Valley where protests persist, public trust won't be rebuilt quickly. Still, this tunnel stands for something rare, long-term resolve. In a world of short-term headlines, it reminds us that transformation takes time and digging. Lots of digging. So is this the world's priciest hole in the ground or a lifeline for Europe's climate and commerce? Only Europe's resolve will decide. So what's your take? Will the Mont-Aubin tunnel become Europe's boldest rail achievement or just its most expensive hole in the ground? Should freight shift from roads to rail even at 14 billion euro? Can mega projects like this balance climate goals with local concerns? Drop your thoughts in the comments, especially if you're near the Alps or work in transport. And if this journey into Europe's underground ambitions gripped you, like, subscribe, and hit the bell to join our next mega project deep dive.